And you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh Lord. And you are wonderful. You are worthy, oh God. Let's just bless the name of the Lord. Let's continue in the service in an atmosphere of worship. In an atmosphere of reverence, he's wonderful. He deserves all the praise. He deserves all the glory. Oh Lord, we bless your name. Maleno Shila Limo Celebro Zeta Limo Sianinosia. I hear in my spirit celebrate Jesus. Likanto Subraleta. Can we be intentional? Can we focus on the Lord? Likamasunimo Sianino Siana. We lift you up, Jesus, the head of the church. We celebrate our risen King. We celebrate him that was wounded for our transgression. Yes, we celebrate the bright and the morning star. The Lamb of God that takes away the sin of the world. Libo shata mahati. Likokole sike rezuso pralete ki kono sente limosia. The head of the church. Le pasondo legedia. The fourth man in the midst of the fire. Le kaseto pare nonto seke. Irabo sika mamamondo sia. Our kinsman redeemer. Yes, you are the great bishop of our souls, the mediator between God and man, even the man Christ Jesus, the apostle and high priest of our confession. The star of David, the bright and the morning star, our great physician, the chief cornerstone, the desires of the ages, the delight of the Father, the last Adam, Aratakaya, the life-giving spirit, the first begotten from the dead, the second man, the word of the Father, we celebrate Jesus, our elder brother, the one who is not ashamed to call us brethren, saying, I will declare your name before my brothers, the first fruit, oh Jesus, glorious things are spoken concerning you, King of righteousness, Prince of Peace, wonderful counselor, we stand to proclaim that of the increase of your kingdom and of peace there shall be no end, for your government resides upon your church, and your church is marching on, and the gates of hell will not prevail against it. The builder of the church, the plumb line of the church, le parete kino sondo balekeni bo sanda na bosia.
Yes, it was you that gave your blood for us to raise up a church without blemish, without spot, without wrinkle. And so we see the glorious church, the bride of Christ. We see her. We see the new Jerusalem. We see the army of God. We see a people that have been equipped, walking in the love of the Father and walking in unity. Yes, we see the church. The formidable force, mighty in declaration. Yes, that is what we see. The church of faith and the church of Christ and the church of power and the church of glory. For the mountain of the Lord's house, even in this season, is being exalted. And the Lord, is visiting his church once more. Just like Bethlehem Judah received the visitation. And the Lord is really, I'm seeing fresh bread. And even in this season, the Lord said that the shoe bread, even the bread of his presence, will be made available. That men, will begin to taste of the good word of God. Is the season of the church. Is the season of the church. For I am arising to prune my body so they will bear more fruit and bring glory to the Father. And I'm raising saviors that are springing forth out of Zion. Give attention to the parable of the feet. That is what I hear in my spirit. That when it putteth forth its leaf, know that harvest has come. And don't begin to say in your heart that there are yet 4 months. Don't begin to look at the physical structure of the church and say, no, this church is not ready. Look at the parable of the figs. 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 And I hear the riddle that played with the baker. And the butler, for even Joseph proclaimed that in 3 days you will be reinstated. For even in this season, the church has stepped into her third day. For I said in my word, after 2 days, I will revive you. And the third day, I will resurrect you. You have stepped into the days of reinstatement and revival and resurrection. This is the time. That you are coming into full bloom, you are coming into maturity, you are coming into strength. Shift your focus, and I see the serpent that is lifted up, even the same serpent that was lifted as a brazen serpent in the wilderness. And I see snake bite, and the Lord said, don't focus on the bite. Look unto me, for your salvation draws near. As you focus on me, there will be healing for every wound, for every bite. There will be restoration. For I say again, it's a season of reinstatement of the church. For in this season, I stand as the head of the church to raise up one and to pull down another. For the next 7 months, there will be restructuring in the body of Christ. There will be displacement. Mighty saints will be called home. And there'll be repositioning. And even of generals that I have placed in the wilderness. Equipped and prepared for such a time as this. And even in this season, I will bring them to the limelight. When you see the generals go, it becomes a sign to you. For the riddle that played with Moses and Joshua is playing out in your time. And once more I hear that Moses, my servant, is dead. It is time for the Joshuas and it is time for the Calebs to lead the army to possess territory. For yes, there are gates and there are territories that I have allotted to your generation. There are mountains that you must take. It is time for the daughters of Zelophehad to arise and contend and negotiate for their land. I'm apportioning territories for the angel with the measuring line is going forth right now. A radical cemetery, Mosianosia, and new visions and the temple seek and temosiana. I see templates in the spirit and taking contemporary contosia. And I hear the former things are passed. La sato que la sequenia, a redoso pretelegadia, a reton contosi manegonosia. Expect mighty visitations. I see rain, and I see fresh straw and fresh grass. And I see an angel carrying wine. And I hear the Lord say, I am serving wine, even the wine of my spirit. Your meetings will be characterized by mighty outpourings of the spirit. Men will be slain in the spirit. They'll be drunk in the spirit. For I serve this wine. And in this season, you will learn to cooperate with the host of heaven. They will be more visible. Strategies will be released. Insight will be released. Understanding into 50 years. I see the years. I see 50 and I see understanding. Light shining inside into the next 50 years. For you have stepped into the days that the prophets of old prophesied about. And even in this season, you will receive help, massive help, not just by angels, but spirits of just made prophets. I hear guardians, I hear watchers of territories. And I see a mighty eagle in the spirit. And I hear the Lord say, I equip you with sight. For I will no longer speak in parables to you. I will come plainly to you. Get ready. You have stepped into the days declared in scripture where two will be grinding and one will be taken away. And two will be lying down and one will be taken away. There's going to be a massive catch up. Men will be caught up into the realms of glory. And I see a faucet in the spirit opened. And I hear the Lord say, I restore once more the realms of glory. You'll be walking on the earth, and you will not know when you have moved out of this plane and you have stepped into glory, and you will move back into the earth and you will move into glory. It will be easy. For the middle wall of partition, I have pulled down, and you begin to have glimpses and the tenderness Italia of the realms of glory. I hear the Father say, Arama Sekinatosia Mondosia Nabosia and Nabosia, Arido Bontosivan and the Sivanata. Get ready for mighty signs and mighty miracles. Erenekeno Montosia Montalia, for the atmosphere of my glory is the atmosphere of miracle. Leginoto Putekifatico Nombosia Nondosiana, notable miracles. Arradomontuseveyenden Kiabos. That there will be no doubt, miracles that cannot be faked. Le passe ki kasiko soto fota sefe. Esti enosi se enosi ananosia. And I see a great cloud of witness, and they pull back the curtain, and I hear them say, yes, it is time. Le panu tesi kadeti taya. And I hear the Lord say, as encouragement to you, I send you help. You are not alone. Those that are with you, those are with you. They are mighty and they are strong. When you feel afraid and when you feel intimidated, look inwards and look around you. We thank you, Lord, for rivers in our deserts. We thank you, Lord, for rivers of refreshing. We thank you, Lord, for the river of life. We thank you, Lord, for the river that we cannot swim. And I hear the Lord say that even in this season, it will not be by your effort. It will not be you seeking me. It will be me pulling you. It will not be you crying for encounters. It will be me meeting you. Emma singing to Zukan de Hinos Yananosia. And I hear also the value of decision. For there's a mighty visitation in the value of decisions. For a mighty harvest is coming forth from the value of decision. And I give you sickles, new sickles, and I make you new sharp threshing instruments, having teeth. And even in this season, my breath comes upon you. It's the breath of the Almighty. And I see a mighty eagle flapping wings in the spirit. Oh, Jesus. I breathe the winds of freshness over you, fresh breath over you. I am Papa Eagle. I bought Jeshurun on the wings of my eagle. And even right now, I come with that dimension to pay you up in eagle's wings, that you will ride on the heights of the earth. And even now, I give you the choices of wine. And that is why you saw the angel serving wine. Aranote Sianosia is the wine of my presence, the cup of my presence. Aradeke de Montosia, you will run, you will not be weary, you will walk, you will not faint. And again, the Montosia, I release Aladika Lesutelemosia, supernatural power, divine enablement. And again, no sumeneti, I see people taking off. In the realm of the spirit, and I see their feet not touching the earth, and the Lord says, it is not by might, it is not by power, it's the walking. Alesuke vateke siya, obono tonge diko tosi kene diko tosu se siya, esti fino sifahia, emphasis ni hefeya, esti finta sinafeya, enusa siya nemfose, se finto si sefena, esefina, estefona, estefona, estefosia, estefosia, heaven forces, heaven forces, heaven air forces, heaven air forces, esti forces, venesia nosia, nesia mosia, nemosia, nosia, nemosia, they will strike from the air. These are air forces, but they are heaven forces. Manokotosika, nemosika, nemosia, they will not war. Lebaseki tosu, kelekatia mosia, baratosi, baranosia, but with the armory of the flesh, for they will understand. Manegino tosi, manetongon, di, ton, 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 yes, they will understand the tools for navigating the airwaves. In this season, I reposition my church to take on air territories. And even right now, I release resources. For I hear one say, how shall we do these things? For this work, I've released the ministers of resources. And I've opened the treasures of heaven. And you begin to receive supernatural abanetosia provision, barrekendosia, unusual opening, arradosia nosia, in the airwaves and in the media, ala sekenegenosia, and you will go forth and you will stand as my voice, alekinamosia, and you will decree my decree, arradosi kamata, and release my counsel to the ends of the earth, ayakenobosia nosekelea, erradekedosia, arrademontosia monta, for even in this season, I stand. To visit the nations, and I hear Brazil is being visited even right now. And I hear one ask, what about Nigeria? And I hear in my spirit, and they give no sopranate. As a matter of fact, I see a court session, and I see negotiations, I see books of destinies and books of nations being raised, and I see one stand for Nigeria, and I see written on it, Nigeria shall be saved. Le basete ne tia, eredi koto baneteva, enengi dosu kentinken dosa, enigondo patite nivadeya, eretenken tosu bara, eritosu na paletia, eretenken duseketeya, endosu konon dosu kedegeya. I see wildfire springing from Brazil, and then kenton kontosi vanagadosia, and I hear Argentina will be pivotal in this season, and the guitars of Pralate see for open the gates of Argentina, and then don't go to Patinka de Gerosia, and there's a mighty visitation over Latin America, Le Baseke Tegia Vosa, and Renonton Kuntesia Nanosia, and I see one put his hand on China, and I hear the evil one, Manegiso Otokosekia Vosia Rosia, Redeketo Kondosika de Catesia, and Redeketo Subanagadosia, Vanosia Nabosia, did a word in that nation, La Bono Tosica Nagadosia, but that which is meant for evil I have turned for good. For saviors are springing out of China. And I hear Canada. Radical transformation. I hear New Zealand. In this season you will stand as a mighty oak, a pillar of strength. I hear recover Britain. I hear recover Britain. I hear recover Britain. Ramazan, the enemy seeks to encroach and to take of Britain, but I hear recover. I hear recover. I hear recover. Radakata mashata egenesikota egenosia. I see Kenya mezesi vota alegedede radeta teza ozama mamamaya alegedede. And I hear to the nation that sits in great darkness, a great light has appeared. I see a great light over Kenya. Manegete bondo si ehevo soso voto seze 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 seya. Mighty souls coming from Namibia and and I hear the fugitives of Sudan will be restored. For the mighty waters of Ethiopia will be healed. Oh Jesus, and I see a mighty angel with a trump, and I hear blow a genedega, blow salelosa, alegedega. In Gobondosia, Manedosia, Manedosia, the trumpet in Zion, Manekidosia, Manedosia, and I say to my church, this is not the season to be at ease. I see Donald Trump receiving mighty visitation. I see the hand of the Lord come upon his shoulders. Eganegi Gokopake, Kakuka, Gahaika, Hikoko, Koriso, Kokolo, Siga, Yekasia, Ezisi, Tosi, Petetito, Zefito, Totofi, Tete. E forty se evil, si se forte, vite lefri torte via, every so for the hofasia, esi so socria tetianosia, and the council of the Lord, we prevail in United States of America, le gaden gunta hadi kadiga, gadi kutu tu tuza, in non tuto do dozia, for the wells of the fathers that have been dug in that nation, and the gimontosia that the Philistines have stout, le banonte sic and negrosia, I see a mighty generation arise and unstop those wells. Enter second negadia ho. Oh shabala hande negadosia. We give you praise, Jesus. Oh shabala hande ha. Irabo seke mahunesia karibosia. Lebabale so ya. Great and mighty is our God. Ashala bakuri basia dosia. Oh, we give you thanks, Jesus. Labosita. Remondosi Seriadosia. Thank you for rivers in our deserts. Eshanosia Mundosia. I hear the Lord say, I'm visiting the waste places and the desolate places, and I'm restoring desolate inheritances. Iaboshata Labakoro Boseke Negikatosaya. Oh, Janeke no Bosuke Nehiko no Supradesia. Likando so prade do so prade iko roma singa riba babamande ko rondo suzanina lita. I'm saying mantum zazimon siza yabosiza kedios yabosia. Oh fathers, ika valosiza kedebosia. I'm seeing commissionings, ika lendo subaledosia, that some fathers were not able to fulfill, they were not able to end, because the enemy caught them in their pride. Ika rosinatosia. I'm seeing azikorotosia, the baton being passed on, elegino subreteya, and I hear this legacy, kale suseporoti karegedosia. Repasoko to breketiko sopralesi kakarate keresia. Eresuketeria bosia. This legacy of faith, mazeku to subale, will not be lost. Emasusekena divosia. For a new generation is receiving fresh baptism from the Lord. And so we give you thanks, Jesus. Oh, blessed be the name of the Lord. Can we just pray in the spirit and agree with the word of God? Don't be like that man that said, how will these things be? And Prophet Elijah said, you will see and you will not enter into it. Oh, the Bible says, blessed is she that believes, for there shall be a performance. Ikola sekutarivo. Oh, shandalabo, 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 repakondo sikabarikondo bradeke rikondu baratasia. We give you thanks, Jesus. Esefre de hondosia. Oh, you see, when you enthrone him, we started with the word I heard, celebrate Jesus. When you enthrone him as the governor, when you enthrone him as the government, when you enthrone him, the word of God declared that he is the king, he is the judge, and he is the lawgiver. When you enthrone him as the judge of the earth, when you enthrone him as the lawgiver, when you enthrone him as king, then he stands to preside over the nations. Jesus, we lift you up. We thank you for our audience. We thank you for everyone that is streaming from all over the world. Oh, we thank you for that which you are set to do, that which you have already begun to do. We thank you for the mighty transformations we see with the eyes of faith. We see with the eyes of faith. I hear again, give attention to the parable of the fig. I hear it again, give attention to the parable of the fig. It is wisdom to you in this season. And so, Father, we give you thanks. Glorious God, beautiful King, Waymaker, miracle worker, we bow before your throne. Thank you for visiting us. Thank you for the spirit of prophecy, which is the testimony of Jesus. We thank you, spirit of truth. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you. Jesus, we thank you. In Jesus' name, amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Our God is awesome. Wow. I hope we'll be able to minister God's word. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Excuse me. Well, I'm going to be looking at the army of the Lord. And I just want to talk briefly. I believe I'm done here. I believe what the Lord wanted me to do was to prophesy. He did plan on doing that, but it just rolled. But just to give us a word to be able to navigate the season, let's go to the book of Ephesians chapter 6, and we'll start our reading from verse 10. It says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this age, against spiritual hosts of wickedness in the heavenly places. Therefore, take up the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day. And having done all to stand therefore, having girded your waist with truth, having put on the breastplate of righteousness, and having shod your feet with preparation of the gospel of peace, above all, taking the shield of faith, with which you will be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one, and take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, being watchful to this end with all perseverance and supplication for all saints, and for me that utterance may be given to me, that I may open my mouth boldly to make known the mystery of the gospel, for which I am an ambassador in chains. Praise the Lord. Now the Bible says in verse 16, Ephesians chapter 6 verse 16, it said, above all you do, that you should take the shield of faith, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the adversary. You see, in this season, for a while, in the bulk of the messages I've done, both offline and online, we've been re-examining faith as a foundation. And the reason why we're doing that is because the Bible says that the church, you know, what we came into as born-again Christians is called the faith. We came into the faith. And then as a matter of fact, the Bible also says that without faith, it is impossible to please God. So if we want to live a life that is pleasing unto God, that means we must give attention to faith. Now Romans chapter 1 verse 17 says that the just, those of us that have been justified, shall live by faith. And Romans 10, 17 says that this faith comes by hearing, and hearing the word of God. So you see that faith is not something that you should toy with. Given the fact that we have stepped into dangerous waters, we are treading on treacherous ground. We have stepped into a season that the Bible refers to as perilous times. It's a season where the word of God tells us that we must end. We don't have any other option. This is not the season to fall. The Bible said if you fall or you faint in the day of adversity, it is because your strength is little. This is not the season to faint. This is not the season to be weak. This is the season to stand. The Bible said we stand and then we withstand and then we stand also. But you see, he has equipped us. God did not just leave us like that. He gave us armor to walk with. He gave us the shield of faith. He gave us the helmet of salvation. He gave us the sword of the spirit. He gave us the word of God. He gave us a lot of things. Now the Bible is saying that above all that we do, we should take the shield of faith. Ephesians 6 says, he said, above all. That's it. You are taking your sword, you are putting on your helmet, you put on the breastplate, your loins are girded about with truth, your feet shod with preparation of the gospel of peace. He said, above every one of these things that you do, that you should take the shield of faith, which is the word of God. Take the shield of faith, which is the word of God, wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked one. So we have a responsibility. Nobody is going to take the shield for you. You take the shield. You take the shield. It is your work. It is your responsibility to do what? To take it. You are conscious. You are deliberate in your action of taking on the shield of faith. Now, how does this faith come? It comes by hearing. We see that in Romans chapter 10, verse 17. It comes by hearing and hearing the word of God. It means that if you are going to take on the shield of faith, then you must give attention to God's word. In fact, as a matter of fact, if you looked at all the armor that we have been given, every one of all of them deals with the word. You talk of the helmet of salvation. You can't talk salvation outside the word of God. You talk of the breastplate of righteousness. It's the word of God that makes you understand what righteousness is. You look at your loins that are get about with truth. What is truth? The Bible says, sanctify them with your word. Your word is truth. So the word also is true. Every part of our armor is the word of God. But the Bible is now telling us that above all that we do, we should take on the shield of faith. Take on the shield of faith wherewith you shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the evil one. So in this season, we see the enemy hitting us with darts. COVID-19 is a fiery dart. Ebola was a dart. Cancer is a dart. HIV is a dart. There are other darts that the enemy is sending our way. He's sending poverty. He's sending infirmities. He's sending depression. Last year we saw... I don't know if you took notes, but you will see that the rate of suicide increased. Children were just taking their lives like never before, like a spirit of suicide was just unleashed on the face of the earth. We're seeing people all of a sudden taking, I was listening to the news yesterday, and they're saying that people are taking antidepressants, that it increased at 40% level. And they were saying that the fear of COVID-19 had brought depression on the people. This is CNN. And then I'm wondering that, people are not even dying because of COVID-19. Now, depression is now, they are now getting afraid and they are becoming depressed and they are taking depressants. And you know what antidepressants can do to people? So the enemy is releasing all forms of doubt at all. But the Bible said we have the cure. And what is that? The shield of faith. You take it and you quench. And the beautiful thing about this scripture, Ephesians 6:16, is that you can quench all the fiery darts. So, in this season, we're seeing because of the pandemic, people have not been able to go to work for a while, and you are seeing hunger, you are seeing the armageddons, you are seeing the low income earners, you are seeing all sorts of people crying out to government for food, and then you are seeing armed robbery being increased, and the Bible said violence will not be known at our street. We're seeing fear. You talk to people and people are afraid. They don't know what will happen next. Oh, we don't know when this thing will go away. We don't know when it will come. We don't know if lockdown is the solution, if it is not the solution. And you are hearing all sorts. You put on your various media platforms and you hear all sorts of information. Today they are telling you it's this. Next tomorrow they are telling you it's 5G. Another time they are telling you it's mask. You hear all sorts of things. Even the mask itself. To even wear it, you cannot breathe. So the mask itself is a problem on its own. You have all sorts of things being slammed at humanity. But you see, Jesus Christ said, cheer up, John 16:33. He said, I have overcome the world. That is our confidence. Our confidence is not in the world. And that was why he gave that prophetic word. If we're listening, I saw in the spirit, I saw the braces have been lifted up. And I saw little snakes by the side. And the Lord said, don't look at it. COVID-19 is one of those snakes. The snake of Moses, the serpent of Moses swallowed all of other snakes. And I'm telling you that the serpent of Christ that is lifted up swallows up any other thing that is a serpent that wants to hit us, whether it is COVID-19, whether it is whatever name they want to call it. The serpent of Christ that is lifted up, that was a type and a shadow of Christ that was lifted up. He swallows it up. So we take the shield of faith and we quench the fiery dart of the wicked one. How do you do that? The Bible said, we have in the spirit of faith. According as it is written, we believe, therefore we speak. You take faith by believing and speaking. The Bible said in Romans 10, with the heart you believe, with the mouth you confess. You don't say, I have faith, and you keep quiet. As we say, a closed mouth is a closed destiny. How do you quench the fiery dart of the enemy? You don't see him carrying arrow running at you. No, nobody sees it. He's an invisible enemy, because the Ephesians already tells us that we are warring with principalities and powers. We are warring with unseen forces. So what do? You speak the word of God. The Bible calls it the sword of the Spirit. In Revelation 19, it describes Christ, you know, when he was going to warfare, and he said he was putting on a vesture that was dipped in blood, and the Bible said in his mouth was a sharp sword, which is the word of God. So you release the sword of the word through your mouth, which is the word of faith. He said the word is nigh us, which we preach, even the word of faith. Taking the shield of faith is releasing the word of faith through your mouth. You are not speaking word of faith. You are not saying, I will live and not die. No. You say it boldly. You say it with the spirit of faith. You say it from your spirit that I know that my Redeemer liveth. I know that Christ died in my place and haven't died for me. You don't pay for a goods two times. I will not die. I will live to declare the faithfulness of God. You declare God's word with long life. He satisfies me. You are looking at your finances. You are looking at your children. They are crying for food. Probably you just went to the ATM this morning and you withdraw the last amount that you had. You are going to look at that finance and you will speak God's word to it. You will tell it. The cruse of oil will not run dry. You will prophesy to it. The Bible said the building prospered by the prophesying of the people. We have the word of prophecy in our mouth. The testimony of Jesus is the spirit of prophecy. Take the word of faith and speak to your situation. Your body all of a sudden, you just wake up at night and probably you are having, you know, breath dysfunctionality, and a voice whispers and says, I called them, it is COVID-19. People were having asthma and were having breathing problem before COVID-19 came. So don't call it COVID-19. Call it another thing. Call it an attack. Speak the word of God. Bind that demon that wants to take your breath away and cast it away. And then, you know, other things that he just slams at you. But you see, you cannot be effective in taking the shield of faith when you don't have God's word. And it is not the word of God that you put under your pillow at night when you want to sleep. When the enemy comes, you don't have time to. That's not the time to say, oh, it's exam time. You know, when we're in school, you have people that oftentimes they will not read. I heard something Reverend Chris Oyakilome said, and really I laughed. He said, have you seen those people in school that when it is time for exam, when they enter the exam hall, they will not read instruction. They will just fire down.
and let me write the ones that are easy. Bang, 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 bang. They will write all the easy ones. By the time they are done, then they will go to number one. They will see the instruction. Number one is compulsory, 40 marks. Meanwhile, they spent their time attending to the easy one. They said, oh, let me quickly attend to number one, which is the one carrying 40 marks. That's when the lecturer will say, and he said, you did it in year one. You did not learn. Year two, you did the same mistake. Year four, you are still doing it. That means you have already failed. The word of God that you don't understand is instruction. How do you work with it? You are faced with a situation. You say, heaven help those who help themselves. Is it in your Bible? It is not there. No. You take God's word. You don't read during the exam. People will go partying in school and doing all sorts. One day to exam, they'll put their feet in water. Take Nescaf. Lick all sorts of things. Carry the book and sleep inside the water. Because that is not, you are doing the right thing at the wrong time. Now, in the midst of the pandemic, for a lot of us, unfortunately, we didn't have God's word. And we saw that our faith had been wavering. But you see, there are others that will come. I'm not the prophet of doom. It's in the scriptures. Many things will come. But for us, the saints, for us, he said it is those that know their God. Know your God by taking scripture. Know your God. He's not saying, I know Jesus of Nazareth. Jesus, here are you. No, know your God is knowing this word. Know your God is knowing how to appropriate scriptures. Know your God is knowing when you are faced with an attack, that is not the time to say, for the food we're about to eat, we bless you, O God. No, 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 that is wrong appropriation. No, that's the time you take, you know, you take Psalm 23, for example, and you are saying, even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. That's the time you take Psalm 121 and you are declaring God's word that the Lord is your keeper, the sword will not smite you, the Lord preserves you from all evil. When you are faced with all forms of things, you know the word to apply. Well, if it is infirmities, you know that it is by his stripes I am healed. And other scriptures that has to do with that. If it is death, you take scriptures that have to do with life. If it is hunger, you know the word of God to appropriate. The Bible says when you take the sword of the Spirit, when you take the word of God, which is the shield of faith, you can quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. So this morning, by the grace of God, we are going to, for the next 5 minutes, as we round off, we are going to be quenching all the fiery darts of the wicked one. We are going to pray in the Spirit for like 2 minutes, and after that, the next 3 minutes, you are going to be declaring God's word. And even when we go off air, you might need to return to your chores or whatever work you are doing. Take out time in the course of the day. At night, before you sleep, spend time in just speaking the word of God. You see, Jesus Christ declared in John 6:63, he said, the word I speak, they are spirit and they are life. The word of God is powerful. It is quick. It is sharper than a double-edged sword. It can cut off the hand of the adversary in your life. So begin to pray in the Holy Ghost. Father, we give you thanks for the entrance of your word that has given us light and has given us understanding. Thank you for the prophetic word. Thank you for the word of life. Thank you for the word of faith. Father, we give you thanks. Shando koba reke dosa leke derke dosa talebo siane telia. We give you praise, Jesus. La pros deleke ninto siana bosia. Give him thanks, be deliberate. Libroto, let the river of life in your spirit, let it flow out of your mouth. Le parose keyata, 1 more minute. Ikanusa teleke ninto bradesia. O zambratazi karetos de brenatosu ratane ketia bosa. And tiki ven and dos. You know what you are doing is that you are stirring your spirit man. Apostle Paul told Timothy, he says, stir up the spirit. Stir your spirit man by praying in the Holy Ghost 30 more seconds. I'm hearing the scripture that says the race is not to the swift. No, no, no. It is not by your effort. It is of the mercy of the Lord. Can we receive mercy of God?
God. In this season, can you cry out like blind Bartimaeus and say, Lord, have mercy on me. Can we go to the throne of grace and obtain mercy? Father, we receive mercy for our nation Nigeria. We receive mercy for the church of God in Nigeria. We receive mercy for our families. We receive mercy for Christ Life Spring Center. We receive mercy for all our online viewers. We receive mercy for ourselves. We receive mercy in the name of Jesus. Now the centurion told Jesus, he said, you don't need to come to my house. Speak the word only. The Bible said in Job 22, you will decree a thing and it will come to pass. 2 minutes, begin to decree the word. Or begin to speak God's word. Decree God's word. He said, when you decree his word, that light will shine upon your way. Where there is darkness in your life, when you speak God's word, you are introducing light. Not by saying, let there be light, but every word of God is light, it is life. So speak God's word. Speak it now. I am the healed of God. By the stripes of Jesus, I am healed. The angels of God, they give attention to me. And even right now, they minister the life, the resources, the strength of heaven to me. They encamp round about me, round about my family, round about all that pertains to me, round about members of my ministry. And they preserve us from evil. Yes, I declare that the Lord has blessed me with all spiritual blessings in the heavenly places. I am the blessed of the Lord. Hallelujah. My going out is blessed. My coming in is blessed. What I set my hands to do, prophesy it, declare it, call your business. My business is Christ Life Spring Center. It's the King's business. It is blessed. Call it by name. The works of your hands, they are blessed in the name of Jesus. If your children are around you, place your hands on them and speak over them. Prophesy to them. Tell them they are blessed. Speak over your spouse. Speak over your parents. Speak over your siblings. Declare God's word. You are blessed in this season. We speak over our finances. It will not deplete. The cruse of oil will not run dry. We declare we have stepped into the overflow, that even right now we receive supernatural alerts in the name of Jesus. We receive divine wisdom, or to carry out the various things God has placed in our hearts to do in the name of Jesus. The Lord teaches us to profit. The Holy Unction instructs us in all things. We are the blessed of the Lord. I declare God's blessing. I'm seeing fresh oil over us. Oh, Father, we thank you for anointing our head with fresh oil. Thank you for our horn that you've exalted like that of the unicorn. And thank you for anointing us with fresh oil. And I hear the Lord say to you that you are a palm tree. Every part of you is useful. That if useful, even in this season, don't look at just one area. Multiple streams of income. You've been doing business, and because of the lockdown, it is short. Look at other areas. There's wisdom there. I'm seeing green grass. The Lord is saying the land is green. There's a supply. There is grace. There's a release of strength. I'm seeing the fountain of life. Rivers in your dry places. I release it in the name of Jesus. The hand of the Lord comes upon you. The blessing of the Lord is upon you. The angels of God go with you. I speak over you today that you are blessed. In all you do, you are blessed. Your family is blessed. I speak over you that no weapon formed against you shall prosper in the name of Jesus. And every tongue that rises up against you in judgment, I declare they are condemned and they are judged in the mighty name of Jesus. It is well with you and it is well with all that pertains to you. In Jesus' name we have given thanks. Amen. God bless you.